Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Friends, today we're going to learn a concept which is known as debt coverage ratio formula. One of the important ratio. Why? Because of the reason that every bank or the financial institution or any stakeholder who has lended their money to the company will make sure that their money is safe. Their money is in the safe pocket. So the only way to determine whether their money is safe, whether the money will be in a position to be recovered, then for that, debt coverage ratio formula is the most vital ratio that can be used to determine such level of situation. Let's see the formula and let's understand the whole concept. The debt coverage ratio formula shows something like this: the net operating income divided by the debt service cost. I am pretty much sure that you must not have got a clear idea, so we'll understand this. See, we use debt coverage ratio formula to determine how much the net operating income of the firm can generate in terms of the debt payment it has to make in some period of time. Now, let's look at the debt coverage ratio formula to understand more properly. The debt coverage ratio is equal to your net operating income divided by the debt service cost. So this is going to be the formula for the debt coverage ratio. Let's take an example on this so that you may have some idea regarding what we are talking about. Let's take a practical example to illustrate how we can calculate the debt coverage ratio formula. Let's say there's a guy called John, and he has been looking for his company name is also John Inc. Let's say he has been looking for debt financing. They approach nearby banks and financial institutions. So John Inc. has found out that the debt service cost would be around, let's say, 40,000 debt service cost. Let's say it is around $40,000. Everything is in dollars over here for a particular period. Now they want to know whether their operating income is enough to cover the expenses. So you are an accountant of John Inc. and you found out the operating income for the particular period. The operating income for the particular period is 5 lakh. So would you think that John Inc. should go for the debt financing after all? See, the solution lies in the debt coverage ratio calculation itself. As an accountant, you should first see the proportion between the net operating income and the debt service cost. So the formula for the same lies in over here. The debt service coverage ratio, we'll just copy down the formula here. And let's put down some numbers. So our answer should go as is equal to our net operating income, which is 5 lakh, divided by the debt service cost, which is 40,000. So that means over here, as per the ratio concern, John Inc. has enough operating income to cover the debt service cost. I mean, it's 12.5 times. However, the accountant also needs to see whether the similar companies under the same industry have similar to a closer results. So, or the accountant can also check the norms of the industry to be certain that 12.5 is a good proportion. Right. So, remember one thing. Basically, what you are trying to do is you are trying to determine whether this 40,000 will it be able to be covered up from the operating income. Now, instead of this, had it been over here 30,000, this would have changed to 0.75, which is actually not good, which is less than 1. So it's not in a good condition. So you can change the numbers and determine what exactly is going around. Now, we'll understand the explanation part. This was the formula. This was the example. Now it's time to understand the most vital thing, that is your explanation part. See, the formula is important to two groups of an individual. The first group of the people are those who would like to invest in that particular company before they ever loan the amount to the firm. So they want to know whether the firm has enough operating income to cover the payments, right? And the second group of individuals are the internal people, right? The first group of the people are those who would like to invest. I'll just shift it over here. Would like to invest. And second are the internal people. Now, they can be from the top management. You can say the BOD. It can be anyone. They can be from the top management. Or they can report to the top management. So it can be a VP of finance or anyone. So they use this formula to see whether the firm has internal or whether the firm has enough internal operating income to go for the external sources of finance. Right. And external sources of finance means I'm talking about the debt finance over here. Now, by using this formula, we get a very clear idea whether a firm is capable of handling the debt payment regularly. This is the vital thing. If they are not regular, that means there's a default. Recently, the company called INNFS had a rating of AAA, and within just a week, it got dropped down to D. Now, what is the reason behind this? It's as simple as that. They defaulted in all their loans, their bonds, the debentures, everything. And from AAA to directly D. So, remember one thing. If the proportion between the net operating income and the debt payment, if it is too low, like I'm talking about less than one over here, it's better not to go for debt financing. And for the investor, it's better not to loan the amount to such particular companies which are not in a good state. Another example is Jet Airways. Again, a debt stressed company. There is no way the company is able to arrest the stress which has been mounted on the company. In spite of the infusion of 26% of the stake of Etihad, which was somewhere close to 8,500 crores, debt standing at 14,000 crores, they couldn't handle it. Because they had to work on their operating expenses part. So this is how the condition is. And you can imagine how vital this ratio can be in companies as well as the stakeholders course. Now let's understand what exactly is the use of this particular formula. See, before the group of the investor decide to loan the amount of the debt to the company, they look at various metrics. One of the metrics to see whether the company has earning enough operating income to cover the debt payment. If not, then the investor drop the idea of investment to the particular company. So this ratio, debt service, may not only be the formula for the investor to check the stability of the company, but they would like to invest into, but it certainly is one of the most important ratio to check whether the firm or the company is worthy or not. So you can see over here the comparison that higher the net income is good and lower the net income or the net operating income compared to the debt service or the debt cost is bad. So this is the relationship between the net operating income and the debt service cost. Now, I hope you have got a clear and a crystal clear idea regarding this particular formula. The extension of this formula is the DSCR ratio. Again, one of the vital ratio which the financial institution they consider before giving a loan to those companies or the firms.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.